Bande Guru Pada Dandam Bhakta Binda Samannitam Sri Chaitanya Prabhum Bande Nitta Nanda Sahoditam Sri Nanda Nanda Nanga Bande Radhika Charano Dayam Gopijana Samayuktam Binda Vanam Vāñcha-kalpa-taru-vaśya-kipā-sindhu-vevacha Patitānaṁ-pāvune-bhavaiṣṇa-bebhyo-namo-namah Mūkaṁ-karoti-vācālaṁ-pangu-ng-laṁ-ghaita-girim Yat-kipātama-haṁ-vandhi-paramānanda-mādhavam Vṛndhāvai-tulsi-dev-vai-piyāvai-keśava-sacha Shna Bhakti Pade Devi Satya Vattvai Namo Namah Narayana Namaskritta Naran Chaiva Narottamam Devin Swaraswatiṃ Vyasam Tato Jayo Mudire Sankirtane Krishna Kathopadeshe Gauriya Patrasya Prakasane Cha Sadhanurakta Guru Bhakti Yukta Bhakti Pramodaksha Jagod Bharanya Deyam Sada Paribhavagna Mavishchaduham Tethas Padam Siva Virenchanatam Saranyam Bhitatiham Panatopala Bhavadiputam Bande Mahapurushate Charanarvindam Yat Pad Pallavanaka Chandamani Chattai Vispurjita kimapikabhavadu svadarshi Purnanuragara sasagara saramurti Saradhikamai kadakipam karush Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhunitananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasati Gaura Bhaktavinda Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhunitananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Ajānulambita bhujau kanaka badātu Saṅkītanaikabitaru kamala yutākṣa Vishāmbaru dijavaru yugadharmapālu Bande yagat priyakaru karunā bhatāru Hare Krishna Hare Krishna Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. Namami Gange Tava Padu Pankajam Sura Surair Vandito Dibbarupam Bhuktin cha muktin cha dada sinitam Bhavanurupen sada naranam Ganga taranga ramaniya jata kalapam Gauri nirantara vibhushi tobam bhagam Narayano priyamananga madapuharam Varanasi Purapati Bhajavishwanatham Vagi Shajusha Padane Lakshmir Jasracha Vakshashi Jasyasti Hide Sambir Vam Nishinga Maham Bhaji Hare Krishna Hare Krishna Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Nikilo bhuvana maya chinna bichinna karti, bibudo bahulo megyam mukti mohanto datri, shithilito vidiraga radha radhesha dhani, bilasatu hridanitvam bhakti siddhanta bani, bilasatu hridanitvam bhakti siddhanta bani. Gauriya Goshtipati, Sisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur, Jagadguru Prabhupada told that the identity of a real sadhu, real acharya, real Vaishnava is his unique seva mood, non-stop unique seva mood. Gauriya Goshtipati, Sisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Jagadguru told that the real identity of a real Vaishnava, real acharya, real sadhu is his unique, non-stop unique seva mood, continuous seva in his life. Actually, we are going to discuss very sensitive point, which is really impossible to understand. But still, we will have to understand. Without which, this contagious disease actually can spread all around the world. If we can understand Prabhupada, then we can understand Gauranga. If we can understand Prabhupada, then we can understand Krishna. If we can understand Prabhupada, we can understand all Guru Varga, all our Sara Goswami, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Seventh Goswami, everything. So it's a must. So we will have to understand the mood of Prabhupada. Why Prabhupada speaking that? It's a revolting Siddhanta. We cannot accept it, but we will have to accept it. Without accepting this Siddhanta, we will have to go to hell. Because why? Because we can express some doubt about Prabhupada. This way, some of his disciples already gone down. Some of them are gone down. Day by day, they all gone down. Some of them, their group, still today, they are going to deserve that we follow Prabhupada. From the very beginning, they are going to, declare that we obey Prabhupada. We are in the line of Prabhupada. They are speaking from the very beginning. From the very beginning, they are speaking. But their activity is not going to prove that they are going to follow Prabhupada. Like our Jagadguru Prabhupada used to speak sometime, that sometime Agasur, Bakasur, Putana, they all wanted to prove that we are in the line of Krishna. We are in the group of Krishna. Agasur, Bakasur, Polambasur, all they in first hand, preliminary stage in the beginning, they wanted to prove that we are in the group of Krishna. But ultimately their activities, they cannot prove that they are in the group of Krishna. Their activities cannot prove. This way, if we are not foolish, if we can consent unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada, I promise you, you can get all solution. All solution you can, but I know that you are not going to believe me, my word. All solution you can get, all solution. Of course, if you are ready to accept Prabhupada from heart, all his Siddhanta, all his Vicha, everything, unparalleled, unbeaten, we cannot expect. Now our bhajan is more scientific under the guidance of Prabhupada. Nobody can cheat us. Nobody can cheat us. Nobody can cheat us. If we can get the kripa of Prabhupada, that we'll have to do. That's quite impossible, next to impossible. But we will have to do. Actually, Agasur, Pakasur, Prolambasur, Putana, they all wanted to prove. We are already in the group of Krishna, but their activities, we have seen that they are against Krishna. So, somebody can declare that we are in the line of Prabhupada, we are in the line of, you know, Gauranga Mahaprabhu, but their activity is not going to prove. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur told Gauro Bimukh Nijo Jani Jani Por. Though externally you can see that he is my father, friend, wife, you know, my son. But still Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Gauro Bimukh Nijo Jani Jani Por. If they are averse to Krishna, if they are averse to Guru, then we will have to cut relation. Yesterday I told, actually, many times I told, but you forget, you cannot remember. Actually, first step of bhajan is to cut all asasanga from you. No smell of asasanga should be there in our life. Then we can identify we are Gauriya devotee, pure Gauriya devotee. It's quite impossible. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur teaching us that if they are against Gauranga Mahaprabhu, against their Guru Vaishnav, then we will have to cut their relation. If he is my father, still I will have to cut relation. If I discover my Guru Padmatma is against Gauranga Mahaprabhu, oh my God, he is against Gauranga. He is speaking this way, Siddhanta. Then I will have to cut relation immediately. Pitama Abhishya told them, very simple Siddhanta. And who even don't know what to do, what not to do, where is the preliminary Siddhanta? What to do, what not to do? Gauranga Mahaprabhu speaking to Sanatana Gosai. Sanatan, what to do, what not to do? That we will have to get indication from Shastra, from the etiquette of Guru Vaishnava and Shastra. Tasmat Shastra Pramanante Karja Karja Vyavasthita. What to do, what not to do, all reference we can get from Sattik Shastra. But who is not going to follow Shastra, going to claim that I am Guru? All his activities cannot prove. The main problem is there, if you never mind. Main problem, I was shouting like dog. I like dog for all the time. That we will have to preach about Guru Tattva all over the world. If common people can understand someday, this is Guru Tattva, then nobody can cheat them. But we are doing all rubbish. We are not going to sweep. Prabhupada repeatedly told that we will have to discuss about Asraya Tattva. Then automatically we can get entry into that deep philosophy. Oh, Seva Siddhanta automatically. But we are going to jump into Ras Leela. Prabhupada always used to advise, that is the speciality of Prabhupada. That is the unique speciality of Prabhupada. Follow? The Prabhupada always used to say, we will have to discuss about Asraya Vigraha Tattva. Seva Vigraha Tattva, if you are going to discuss, if some acharya is going to mislead you, you can do it very easily because you can feel you have a material karma inside, passive karma. Prabhupada speaking, passive karma is more dangerous than direct karma. Passive karma cannot allow you to understand that karma is there. And gradually, like cancer, gradually you can, all your vitals of your bhajan can go away. You cannot stand in bhajan. It's like cancer, day by day going to eat up all the vitals of your bhajan. So never mind, actually Prabhupada always used to say that we will have to avoid asasanga. And even Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Gauro Bimukh Nijo Jani Jani. If it is my father, if it is guru, if it is mother, or you have to cut relation. Otherwise, no possibility that you can, there is no possibility. How you can do Krishna Bhajan? Not possible. Now point is that many devotees putting this question, Maharaj, how to understand who is genuine, who is not? I say, Maharaj, you will have to become genuine first. Is the answer of Guru Bhargava, Prabhupada. First of all, if you are 100% sincere, If you have no duplicity, automatically I told you, you can get guidance, divine help. Then you can get. Now Prabhupada giving more clue. Prabhupada speaking, yes, you can watch their activities. If you want, they are against pure Guru Vaishnava, their Siddhanta. If you can understand their activities, they are going to prove that we are great Guru Shevak. They can prove that we are great Guru Shevak. But they cannot prove if you are going to get full Kripa Prabhupada. They cannot prove. But they are against, their activities all against Guru Varga. All against Guru Varga, Suddha, Guru Vaishnava, Prabhupada, Bhakti Mutak. So how we can say he is Acharya, he is in the line? How we can say? How we can say then? So Prabhupada speaking, by their activities you can detect. If you have sincerity, then you can detect. Automatically you can understand they are against, their activity is going to prove that they are against Prabhupada and Bhakti Mutak, everything. Like one example, some ex-mission going to identify, we are already in the line of Prabhupada. But their activity is not going to prove that they are in the line of Prabhupada. I can give evidence. I can give evidence. If you are in line with Prabhupada, then how it is possible, how it was possible that you took trouble to publish some books which is just against Koryamar, written by some ex-Binod and Vaibasu? How possible? They are against Prabhupada, against Gauriyamat Siddhanta, everything. They are against, totally against. Kesava Goswami was speaking, so heavy. Kesava Goswami was speaking so heavy that you have no power to hear it. But I am the disciple of Kesava Goswami. How I can change my Siddhanta? Maharaj speaking, they are going to make one big trident to kill Gauriyamat, but they don't know, they cannot kill Gauriyam. They like to. Different kind of, you know, books they compile. Totally, those who are, you know, real Gauriya devotee, they can go through their book, they can understand they are totally against Prabhupada and Gauriyamat. But still, they took trouble after Prabhupada gone in the year of, in the year of 1936, still you can say, after 10 years, 14 years, still I can show their publication of, date of publication. How it is possible for them to publish those books, which is totally against Gauriyamat and Prabhupada. Whereas they are going to claim that we are in line of Prabhupada. This way, if you are blind, then you cannot understand. Anyway, whatever Siddhanta you hear, if you have no Siddhanta, no sincerity, you are blind, how you can understand? That's why yesterday I told, like Prahlad Maharaj speaking, Andha yathandhai rupaniyaman te opisi chatanta murudam nivadya. One blind can never be guided by another blind. But you blind want to rely on another blind. So what to do? Massive preaching of Gauri, of massive preaching of Vaishnav Tattva, massive preaching of Vaishnav Tattva and Guru Tattva is very urgent. Very urgent. All over the world, each and every devotee should understand. Hundreds of Harikatha Tattva on these topics already done. I mean, 4 years, 5 years, all. Who is interested to hear? Yesterday I also told you, to go into this philosophy, you will have to understand, grow your, you know, feeling. You will have to go through this writing. Guru Shevakai Mannoji Amar, already published. Already published in English, already translated and published. You will have to go through all, you know. Now I come to the, I like to come to the point. What I, yesterday I was feeling disturbance due to internet problem. I couldn't speak, excuse me, properly. So, last time, I was supposed to speak more 40, another 40 minutes minimum. Anyway, yesterday I was speaking, we are going to discuss about the unique Acharya Sivasa of Srila Prabhupada, but, the speciality is that, today's discussion, that Acharyaship and Prabhupada. What Prabhupada want to speak about Acharya? We like to clearly understand. We like to clearly understand what do you mean by Acharya and what, why Prabhupada speaking that way? Eh? Why? And how we can digest that? So we like to understand the Siddhanta of what Prabhupada want to speak about Acharyaship, Guru Tattva. And to start with, I like to speak, the Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, that who is Guru? Who is Guru? He is Vaishnava. Who is Vaishnava? He is Guru. Guru means Acharya. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, he is Vaishnava, but not Guru. It cannot so happen. It is impossible. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, who is Vaishnava? Vaishnava means perfect Vaishnava. Who is Vaishnava? He is Guru. And who is Guru? He is Vaishnava. Surely he is Vaishnava. And who is Guru? He is Acharya. So, many times I was discussing about Acharya, Tattva, everything. So, if you can understand, then you can grow your consciousness gradually. Yesterday I was speaking that one sloka from Kathopanishad, Ascharya Asya Bhakta Kusala Asya Labdhya, I was speaking. Today I am going to discuss total sloka. It is written about this very, very, you know, complicated tattva, very secret tattva, Atma tattva, Atma Vigyan, Bhagavat tattva Vigyan. You will have to keep patience and go on serving pure Guru Vaishnava, their Harikas, this, go on. Gradually you can understand. So, Sravanayapi Bahuvir Jona Labhya Sranto Opi Bhavo Jamna Viduhu Ascharya Asya Bhakta Kusala Asya Labdha Ascharya Gnata Kusalanu Sishtaha. Atma Tattva is so complicated, so secret. You know, Guhyam Vishuddhyam Durvadhyam Jadgyatya Amritam Ashnute. It is from, you know, Bhagavadji Mahapran, Ajamil Upakhyan, that tattva there, Jamraji Maharaj speaking, Guhyam Vishuddhyam Durvadhyam Yadgyatya Amritam Ashnute. Come on, man. Without enjoying full kippa of Guru Vaishnava, you can sow one instant who is successful to go to Golok Vrindavan. You can show one example, I like to see. One example, you can show. So, Jamraji Maharaj, one of our great Mahajan, he is speaking. That is very secret tattva, Guhyam. Guhyam means secret of the secret, very secret. Guhyam Vishuddham. Vishuddham means there is no touch of any Maya contamination. Guhyam, Vishuddhyam, and at the same time, Durvadhyam. Durvadhyam means inconceivable. Out of your manpower, out of your money power, out of your educational power, there is no possibility that you can get entry into this transcendental world. If you want to put forcefully you like to apply force, then trespassers will be prosecuted. Trespassers will be prosecuted, this you should remember. So there is no entry. So to get entry, first of all you will have to prove 100% that you are from Gauriya society, Gauriya Mat. That's why Prabhupada told. In Delhi, one educated, you know, young man, why you are speaking this way? That you, without Gaurimat, there is no way. Prabhupada says, yes. Can you show any other alternative of Gauriyamat? If you can show, I can throw my base. Can you show? There is no alternative of Gauriyamat. But all duplicate people going to take shelter in Gauriyamat, then this is not the identity of Gauriyamat. First time you are making mistake, this is not the identity of Gauriyamat. To understand Gauriyamat, you will have to understand Prabhupada. They are all foolish. If you want to express doubt, you can come secretly, one by one I can show what going on. I am not going to fight with them, I have no time. I am not going to criticize them, but I am going to project the fact. This society is so foolish, so foolish. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, what told yesterday was supposed to, I can discuss today. Bhaktivinoda Thakur saying, those who are corrupted, we should, you know, they should be isolated. But who is going to isolate? If I going to do, they can kill me. They cannot obey my word. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Bhagavad speaking, they are not. I can show you what kind of telephonic discussion going on, night time, 11 o'clock, a sannyasi, 12 o'clock. I know, they already confessed that we have fallen down already. But still this society is so idiot. They are going to go, Maharaj, come on, Maharaj. And then what to do? Everybody going to, like terrorist, some country going to the gate, come on here. We can give you place here. Corrupted. But Bhaktivinoda does begin, anyhow we will have to isolate, we have to, you know, they should be isolated from pure society. But who can mention? There is a direct judgment of Prabhupada. Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. Who is going to take up this responsibility? Nobody. Okay. So, reconciliation, we can go atat, reconcile, like voting system, political party, two party. Oh, you can come. You can join with me. We can get vote. So now it is the day of vote. If they are going to show that our vote is high, then Prabhupada can get defeated, Bhaktivinoda Thakur can get it, Keshav Goswami Maharaj can get it. But they can never be defeated by anybody. They can make some group and fight. So, Savarnayopi, so you see, Jamaraji Maharaj, the great Acharya speaking, that Guhyam Vishuddham, you cannot expect this Bhagavad Tattva began in market. You can go here and there. All over the world, if you can make a comb operation, you can show me, you can show me that what speech going on, what speech. If I am going to deliver some lecture in front of you, and that lecture not going to give benefit even to me, I myself cannot purify myself. Harikatha is that Harikatha. I can speak, this is Harikatha, which is going to purify myself. At the same, going to purify all whole world, those who are going to hear. That is called Harikatha. You know the Sarup of Harikatha? Bani Sarup, you know? All foolish people. They like to commit suicide. How to save them? So, Savarnayapi Bhavir Jonalabhya Srananto Opi Bhavo Jangna Viduhu Ashtujya Asya Bhakta Kushala Asya Labdha. Anyway, Maharaj, all over the world, if we search, maybe one or two we can get, they can speak about that Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan from heart. From heart. I am not a university professor that you can expect a nice piece of lecture from me. I am not a, you know, linguist. You can expect some nice language from me. Somehow I am going to express my heart with poor language. I don't know. I know nothing. Uneducated I am actually. So this way I am going to speak. So we cannot expect. But what we can expect from a pure sadhu? We want to expect the feeling he already have received from Gurupad Padma. Direct feeling of seva. Not that only lecture. Who man care to hear your lecture? We have no time to hear your lecture. We have no time to waste our time. We like to understand, we like to feel the feeling. We like to get some feeling, direct feeling. Direct feeling that you can expect from a pure Guru Vaishnava. So Guhyam Vishuddham Durbodhyam Complicacy. You cannot understand. So secret, so pure, Durvadhyam, inconceivable. But still, by the mercy of Sadguru, 100 possibility is there, 100 possibility is there. I must go to Golok Vrindavan by the mercy of Kripa of Guru Pad Padma. We must take resolution this life. We must take resolution this life. We can go to eternal Dham. I cannot wait anymore. I see the situation of this whole world is corrupted situation. I cannot wait anymore. Rupa Goswami Bhat crying and speaking, "Oh Prabhu, better you can put me inside a cage and set fire all around. You can set fire. That even I can bear, but I cannot bear any asasanga." You have that kind of feeling? You grow that kind of feeling? So that you can expect pure devotion? How you can expect? Baram huta vah jala panjarantara vyavasthiti tathapi mukunda vimukha jano vasavaishastam. I cannot bear, Prabhu. You don't give me any bad association anyway. You can put me inside a cage and set fire all around. Maybe burning condition can be there on the body. But still I can bear. But I cannot bear any asasanga. That the thing I wanted to clarify yesterday. Why Prabhupada speaking? Gaur ki vastu. What is the excellent objective? Gauranga Mahaprabhu is to understand. You will have to take resolution. Anyhow, we cannot allow any asasanga. Those who want to step into actual bhajan, it's a must. Otherwise, they cannot expect doing. In the name of bhajan, they can do something. What is not at all bhajan, they can let them do. Who am I to check them? I have no designation, I have no degree, nothing. Who is going to hear me? Okay. No problem. Maybe one devotee can hear me. I'm sure. Maybe one or two. Like some devotee asking in front of Guru Pad Padma Bhakti Mohan, "You are writing whole day and night. Who is going to read, Maharaj? You are writing, whenever we see you are writing." But who is going to? Guru Maharaj with laughing mood speaking, "My son, it is the order of Prabhupada. So I am trying to do this Bani Seva. Prabhupada give me pen and give me, Guru Maharaj also give me order. This way I am trying to do some small seva. Not actually seva, I am trying to do some seva." So Guru Pad Padma speaking, if even one man in the whole world going to read this word and they can change their heart, then I think it is successful. I am not writing to get some name and fame and money. I am writing because it is the order of Prabhupada that I am doing. So it matters little that thousands of people not going to hear. So what is concerned to us? So Savarnayapi Bahuvira Jonalabhyo, after hearing so many lectures, still you cannot understand. What are you speaking? Sravanai api bahuvir jonalabhyo. First of all, transcendental sound vibration you cannot catch. That kind of oral reception power is not there. That is the main problem. The sound coming and going back, bounce. Prabhupada speaking, so much matter, so much material desire, so much dirty thing is there inside our heart, so much aparat. That all of Prakita Harikatha coming like bullet, but bounce, going back. And they have done so much apara, because if you are going to hear from big sadhu, still you cannot, understand. Because if there is aparat, then aparat cannot allow you to understand anything. Consciousness can go drop. Consciousness can go drop. So you see, that Atma, I mean that Atma Tattva is so secret. Even you hear so many lectures, you cannot understand. Because to digest that Harikatha, you will have to take shelter of a Sadguru. They cannot, feel, they cannot get any feeling. What is speaking? We cannot understand what is. Yes. And also, it is also 100%, you know, true that all over the world, if you search such speaker who can speak about that aprakita-tattva transcendental, you know, about that absolute truth, rare, almost rare. Suppose if you can get one or two or three all over the world who is actually speaking. Prabhupada speaking, Gaudiya Math is speaking all about that absolute truth, absolute way. And some other groups, they are also speaking, but not absolute way. So you have no scope to go to Vrindavan, Golok Vrindavan. If there is slight contamination, Krishna cannot allow you. Krishna is very clever. If there is slight contamination, Krishna is very clever. Krishna can play with you. Krishna can test you. Krishna can test you. Heavy testing. Krishna, without testing, Krishna can never allow anybody. Krishna cannot allow. Heavy testing. If you are going to pass, then you can get entry. Otherwise, Krishna cannot allow. Krishna can give you some money, position, woman, position, love, puja, padita, everything. Okay. Je yathamang prapadanti tang sativa bhajamyam. So we cannot expect this kind of mood from Acharya, who is acting as Acharya. We cannot expect. First of all, you learn or try to understand all the tattva of Prabhupada, then you go one by one, try to get, you know, try to see what is happening all around. I am not going to speak anything. Such tattvabid purush is almost rare, who can speak from his direct realization about that tattva vijnan. And even if you are going to get four, three or four or five, but who is going to hear? Eh? Who can catch it? Eh? Ascharya Savaktas Kushala Salabda. Who can catch this Harikatha? Who can digest? Who can understand? It's still rare. I know this kind of Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan, you know, that Tattvavid Purush is very rare, but still more rare. If there is at all, you know, we can get some, but, you know, who can speak, but where we can get, who can, that kind of, you know, Jivatma, who can hear, who can digest, how we can, it's very, very rare, very, very rare. That's why, don't try to misunderstand Prabhupada, don't try to misunderstand Bhaktivinoda Thakur. That is why Bhaktivinoda Thakur always wanted to speak that Mat Mandi Dalan Bari Nakaro Priya. But you are busy with society running. You are putting question, Maharaj, what Maharaj speaking? Then how we can run one society? We are less interested to run one society. We like to run Gaudiya Math. And this Siddhanta is also wrong. Because I cannot run Gaudiya Math. Gaudiya Math can automatically can run. If I am situated in Gaudiya Math, if I am going to obey all the rules and regulations of Gaudiya Math, then automatically Gaudiya Math can run. Nobody needs to run. So I cannot speak this Siddhanta. It is also wrong. I cannot run one Gaudiya Math. Guru Padma told Maharaj, Baba, if you can obey Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada in toto, automatically Gaudiya Math can run. You need not, Gaudiya Math can run you, help you to run with Gaudiya Math, if you are going to obey. So at present, all common people going to think, this Acharya post, this designation is just like a post of a minister. Whatever they do, we will have to accept it. Okay, no problem, they are Acharya after all, okay. Whatever they like to do, they can do, because they have their designation, they have their power, everything they can do. I can remember one very, very small incident. You know, I heard in Calcutta Salt Lake, there is one very nice small flat. I heard it. And there is, you know, one small daughter, maybe is 10, 12 years, and mother is intellectual, father is also intellectual. They are staying in one flat, But actually, to be frank, they are staying in a different Ayas land. They are Ayas land, they are different land. They are staying in one room together, father, you know, mother and the daughter. But actually, to be frank, they are staying isolated. They are totally. They have no adjustment with each other. Someday, mother speaking heavily against daughter. And the daughter, now 11, 12 years, already know the character of mother, everything. So when mother speaking that way, mother speaking, hey, you should not put any argument with me. I am your mother, you know, senior. Then that intellectual daughter speaking, yes, yes, you are right. That is your advantage that you are senior. That is your advantage that is your senior. You are my mother, so you can do anything. I will have to be here. I was just stunned to hear the intellectual answer of that small girl. Really so. Whatever I like, I can do because I am sitting. Maharaj, why I spoke that way, that acharya post is one kind of, you know, punishment. I am not going to speak, you know, against any acharya. I am not going to speak against any Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda. I can prove it. I can prove it why I told him that way. Why I told that way, I have to prove it. So to run a society and to run a prakita Gauriyamat, I mean to stay in Gauriyamat as a manager is not same. You are busy with running one society. You think that any big acharya Vaishnava going to leave his body? So you are so foolish, you are going to think surely that same quality can come in the present acharya. Then all Shastra will have to throw out. We'll have to throw out. So long as he is going to follow in toto all the Siddhanta Vichara Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada and Guru Padmapada Deso, then he can claim that he is acharya. If there is slight disparity, then his acharyaship gets contaminated. That is why Baladev Buddhavasan in Pramaya Ratnavali wanted to speak Niravakara Guru Parampara. We cannot allow any in a contamination in the flow of acharyaship. If we allow, then we can allow the whole Vaishnava society break down 100%. We cannot expect any quality. Quality and quantity cannot persist together. At present, you are busy with quantity. So you are gaining quantity. But you are not busy with quality. You are not at all interested to see the quality. What is the quality of Gauriyamat? If we speak, I am from Gauriyamat, then I become very proud. I become very proud that I am from Gauriyamat. I am from Gauriyamat. So where you are, why you cannot feel that kind of proud that you are from Gauriyamat? Because you are watching all rubbish going on. You cannot believe. Prabhupada speaking for Kamal Saddha, those who are just, you know, very soft belief. Yeah. For them it is very dangerous. Prabhupada speaking, those who are Komal Shraddha, Komal Shraddha means they are Shraddha, their Shraddha is not 100% perfect at present. For them it is very dangerous. If they are going to watch something rubbish going on, they can say, oh, Math Maharaj doing it, so if I do, what's wrong in it? This way all contamination can go on prevailing. So day by day, degradation of humanity, honesty, morality, all going down, coming down to such a deplorable level that even minimum most standard of Vaishnavism we cannot expect at present. Lack of our idealism is just lack of our ideal. We have no idealism. So we are just failure even to achieve the faith of common people of the society, Bhaktivinoda Thakur told. Bhaktivinoda Thakur told, to run a spiritual organization, we need manpower, 100%. We need manpower. But that doesn't mean we can allow anybody come and stay and take, like mess house, hotel. To run a spiritual organization, no doubt we need some manpower. No doubt. But a spiritual organization set up, but a spiritual organization or not, a society set up by some Rajatama, Guna, affected, bonded people, can never project the high, the top idealism of our society, Gauriyama. How we can expect? They have no acharya, and there is nobody to teach them also. Nobody going to teach them. No idealism, how they can teach? So, even they cannot enjoy the faith of this common society. On the contrary, at present, they think, on the contrary, by watching their nasty activities, acharan, the society, present society, they cannot believe. Those who are in renounced order, sannyasi, they cannot believe at present. They are watching everything. We are responsible for that. That's why they cannot even believe. We cannot enjoy their faith. We are going to lose. They are going to lose faith on us. So, by watching their nasty character and behavior, activities, common people of this society like to spit on them. They cannot have any Shraddha. They are going to spit on them. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada used to say, a material man out of his money power can never establish a spiritual organization, a math mandir. You have money power, so you can go and open one month. Ah, Maharaj, I have established, for 10 months. Maharaj, you cannot maintain yourself. You cannot maintain even yourself, your body and mind. How you can control 10 months? You are making some garbage. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur told. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is never against Gauriya Math. Bhaktivinoda Thakur never going to speak, then never try to make any math mandir. But still Bhaktivinoda Thakur bound to speak, mat mandir dalanbari nakaro prayas. Never try to make any temple or brick construction. Why big acharya like Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda, all big acharya. They are speaking this way. Because if we can make mandir, mat mandir, then who is there to get control over this temple? Where is that kind of powerful spiritual personality, gigantic personality? Who is going to influence common people to follow the rules and regulations properly? They themselves cannot follow. So how they can? All rules and regulations for you and me, not for them. Not for them. So that's why Goswami Maharaj never wanted to make any math. Bono Goswami Maharaj never wanted to make any math. He wanted to make a small bhajan group. No, my Guru Pātpa Bhakti Puri Goswami Maharaj never wanted to make any math. Then no, nobody can get control. Big problem. Then, one day, two brahmachari fighting with each other. Fighting with each other on some ground. And Prabhupada was in library. Prabhupada, they are shouting, they are speaking, altercation going on. And Prabhupada gradually coming down, coming out of library, and step by step coming down to meet them. Where there is a hot pot, hot spot or hot pot, where the fighting go, altercation. Prabhupada, 1, 2, 3, 4, Prabhupada going down. After that they watch Prabhupada coming. They stop. And Prabhupada going to identify himself. Yes, it is I myself. It is I myself responsible. I am responsible. Today you have the scope to fight with each other. I am responsible. I am. Why I make Math Mandir? Eh? You are supposed to stay in, you know, forest. You are supposed to stay here and there. Maybe in previous ashram you used to stay in, you know, some, you know, slum house, or maybe mental asylum. Who can say? Otherwise your brain is not pure. Matim satim yachati vasudeve. If your brain is pure buddhi, in Bhagavatam it is written, mati means mind, buddhi. In Sanskrit, mati stilinga, mati matayo. You know, mati is strilinga, feminine gender. You know, it is written in Bhagavatam that mumukshur matim satim yachati vasudeve. If your mati mind is acting like a pure chesty lady, then you can get benefit. If your mind is acting like a pros lady, then how you can get purity of your heart? Follow what I say. Try to understand. Don't become angry with me. Try to understand. Try to come onto a neutral platform. So you see, so if your mind, because Krishna already given in Gita, Uddharet Atmana Atman, Uddharet Atmana Atmanam, Atman Naiva Avsad, No Atman Naiva Avsadayat. You will have to guide yourself. In English we find one word, God helps themselves, those who are going to help themselves. 100% true. Bhaktivinoda Thakur going to speak, don't try to make any Math Mandir, because you are weak. You bonded soul, you weak. You can make some garbage in the name of making temple. You cannot continue because you have no Saranagati. You cannot prove that you have Saranagati. And Bhagavan Sri Krishna going to take your 100% responsibility. 100% responsibility. I know some Matajis. They used to do bhajan in Navadvip, you know, in Vrindavan. I like to take dust particle from their lotus feet. You know. Krishnamayi Didi, you know. Know her name. Her disciple of Srila, you know, Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, my Guru Pad Padma. I like to take dust particle from their lotus feet. So big, you know, Matajis, they used to do bhajan. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, external base and designation is not so important. The main important thing is how they are doing bhajan, how much devotion and dedication they have developed. I know such Matajis, they are already gone. Whole day and night, they used to do seva, you know, of Harinam Prabhu, closing their eyes, shedding tears, you know, all the time. They are thinking about Krishna, they are transcendental, you know. Blind, I know some Matajis, they cannot see. They are blind. They cannot see. They are going outside. Ma, don't go outside. You cannot see. There is monkey, car. They are laughing at me. Ho-ho. Nobody guide, nothing there. With one stick in hand, going to take the darshan of Radha Damodar. Hari Ma, how we can see? If I am idiot, I can put question in front of Mataji. Mataji, you are blind, how you can see? Because I am blind. She is not blind. She can see Radha Damodar from heart. From heart can see. A Siddhanta, countless Siddhanta, we'll have to understand. You know, in Gita, Bhagavan gives assurance, promise. Ananas chintanto mam je jana parjubasate tesham nitabhi yuktanam jo khyamam bahamyaham. Be sure, I am going to take your responsibility, total responsibility. Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Deva Madhav Goswami Maharaj, used to speak in front of their disciple. Also, I printed so many things of Madhu Goswami Maharaj. One letter, Madhu Goswami Maharaj writing to a disciple who is having full of anartha. Maharaj writing, "My son, you want to collect this and that, but you don't know. We are sannyasi, we are penniless. We are coming from our home without any penny. But where from Krishna making this all arrangement?" Madhu Goswami speaking in letter. I already printed in the life history of Srila Bhakti Vallabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj. You know, I already wrote. Maybe 5, 6, 7 years before. There it is written, "Now my son, you see, I cannot do actual bhajan." Madhu Goswami speaking, "My son, look, I cannot do actual bhajan. Still Krishna arranging so many things from me. If I can do actual bhajan, then what Krishna cannot do for me? Krishna is not blind. I am not doing bhajan. Come on, I have no support. I am not going to, you know, beg money from anywhere. You cannot show even a single point. But still everything, all my book publication, all everything going on. How it is possible? So I am grateful to Guru Varga. I am grateful to their advice, Siddhanta Vichar. I am grateful all the time. I am not a traitor to go against them. I am always grateful. How it is possible? Whereas Krishna speaking, that ananas chintyanto mang je jana parjubasate tesham nityabhi yuktanam yogokhyam bahamyaham. Those who are going to think me constantly without any space gapping, they want to worship me, don't to do my bhajan. Tesham mane for them I take responsibility. What they need, I can feel, I can give that thing. What they need, what they have already, by the mercy of Guru Vaishnav, or by the mercy of Baldaji Maharaj, what they are having, it is my responsibility to give full protection. What they have already, I can give full protection. What they don't have, they need it means they are not going, there no demand is there, but still Krishna feeling, I should arrange this facility for, then he can preach properly Harikatha. You know, no smell of any, you know, partiality, no smell of any enjoying mood, then why not Krishna can help? It is written, that's why it is written in Bhagavatam, that kasmad kavayo bhayanti dhanadurmadandha. Why you are going to apply oil on the feet of those rich man? Kasmad bhayanti kavayo dhanadurmadandhan. Those who are blind, dhanamade vidyamade vaishnav na chine, they are so blind, they cannot see who is Vaishnav, what is dham, what is nothing, cannot see. They are actually blind. That Mataji is not blind. She can see Krishna. She can go automatically. And nobody, you know, so she can see everything because Krishna is going to take her responsibility. So we cannot believe, Madhu Goswami Maharaj, we cannot believe that Krishna can take ours. So we are going to arrange. Oh, if I am not going, then who can arrange? I am controlling this month. Yes, you are the boss. You know, you are hero. You are going to take control. A foolish number one. You cannot get control even of your own body and mind. Whereas the Acharya said the first indication, Rupa Goswami was speaking. You know. First indication, Rupa Goswami Pad speaking, na? First indication. I know. Bacho vegam manasaha, all. You know, it is all symptom of one sannyasi's Rupa Goswami Pad, through this sloka, Bacha Vegam Manasoho, Jiva Vegam, Krodha Vegam, Udarapastha Vegam, Etana Vegana Visha Heto, Jo Visha Heto Dhiraha, Sarvam Apinam, Pimam Prithivim Shastishyat. It is the quality, it is the symptom, it is the identification of an Acharya. You are so foolish you cannot understand. You are so foolish you cannot understand. This is the symptom. You will have to follow this. So, who is not having control over his own mind and body, he is going to get control over 10 temples. Maharaj, I'm going to make garbage, illegal children, going to make in the name of Diksha. Prabhupada never approved it. Prabhupada never approved it. So, surely you can make a mutt. Surely Prabhupada can make 46 mutt. Because Prabhupada has power. Prabhupada can make. Surely Keshav Goswami Maharaj can make mutt. Surely Sridhar Goswami. But still, big Acharya. I know practically. Paramahansa Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, Parampujivas Goswami Maharaj, Bhanu Goswami, they never wanted to make bhakti bhava. Then, oh, what I can do with mutt? They are so humble, so humble, so humble. Maharaj, you can go for preaching also. No, no, no. I am not qualified for preaching. I am Sridhar Goswami Maharaj. You go through his writing. You go through his writing. You must go through the writings of Sridhar Goswami Maharaj. So great sadhu. I have no enmity, no partiality, no particle, nothing. You can believe or cannot believe. That's up to you. I can request you. You can go through the writings of Sridhar Goswami Maharaj. Go through the writings of Keshav Goswami Maharaj. But I cannot allow you to go through the writings of those cheaters. I cannot allow. No. I cannot allow. To stop you doing asasanga, I can play different kind of tricks. I am very clever. To stop you doing asasanga, if you are at all going to follow me, I can play different kind of trick so that you cannot get the scope to get asasanga. I am so I am going to express that kind of mood. I don't know if it is mercy or not mercy that you can pass judgment. So Krishna can take all your responsibility. And Rupa Goswami Pad told, he can get control over the whole world. He can rule. He can arrange. He can give rules and regulation. His great sadhu. They have their controlling over their sense organ, mind, everything. It is possible for them. They can do. Only I can pass nice lecture, Maharaj. That lecture can put me into hell ultimately, and then those who are going to follow his lecture, they are also going to automatically they can go to hell. That's why many times I told before, upadesham karoti eva na pariksham karoti ya apariksha upadeshtam yat jagat nasaya tad bhavet. Many times before I discuss, upadesham karoti eva, that sadhu going to give lecture, only upadesh. Hey, you should do this, only upadesh, going to advise you. Upadesham karoti eva na pariksham karoti. What I am going to advise you under the guise of Prabhupada, if I am not going to follow that rules and regulation myself, I have no right to speak. I have no right to speak. If I am myself not going to follow, I have no right to speak. I have no right to speak. If I am trying to follow myself, then maybe by your mercy, all your, Guru Vaishnava can allow me to speak something. Shopadesham karoti eva na pariksham karoti ya aparikshya upadeshtam yat jagat nasaya tad bhavet. I am going to pass this kind of advice to everybody, but this kind of advice is not at all tested in my own life. Maharaj, what I am going to pass lecture, if it is not tested in my own life myself, it is not, then It is going to ruin the whole world. In Shastra it is written, it is going to ruin the whole world. Gradually, you see the situation at present. You see the situation at present. Prabhupada used to say, Acharan hin pachar karmer antargata vishay, Bengali. A preaching without acharan is similar to karma, karma, karma. It is, you are kormi. You are going to preaching field, na? To collect money and position, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing. Arthalab eiyase, bhramiya phiri, deshe deshe. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing. I am not writing. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing. Arthalab eiyase, I can get some money, pranami, I can make some bank balance. So, I am traveling here and there. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, arthalab eiyase, bhramiya phiri, deshe deshe. I am traveling here and there all around the world simply to collect money. Whereas Prabhupada giving instruction, Prabhupada giving that no, it is not our duty to collect money. We cannot collect huge amount of money. We can never collect huge amount of money. That amount of money going to kill me. Kill me. That amount of money, I have huge amount of money. Prabhupada speaking, no, it is not our duty, Seva, to collect huge amount of money. That huge amount of money going to kill me ultimately. Like Ravan. Ravan wanted to collect all money, position, you know, Kamini Kanchan. Ultimately, Ravan was bound to die. This is the result. So, lecture everybody can give. But who can show acharan? That is the main thing. That is the main thing. That is the main thing. So, why our Guru Varga, most of them, they didn't want to make, you know, big, big temple? Because they know, ultimately, nobody going to follow. If somebody going to follow, then nobody going to support him also. Some acharya writing, Maharaj, you are in the line of Guru. Okay, it is, I can think it is your blessing. But you are writing in letter. But physically, mane, physically you are speaking. But from heart you are not speaking. From heart you are thinking, I am an enemy. I know very well. You know. So actually, Srila Prabhupada was bound to establish, you know, Because why Prabhupada took trouble to make? Because it was the instruction of Panchatattva. Panchatattva, Guru Varga, Panchatattva, all Gauriya Guru Varga, they are coming in front of Prabhupada. When Prabhupada was doing 100 crores Nam Yajna, they are coming, hey, you go for preaching. How I can preach? I have no money, no position. Okay, well, we are going to send. All money power, manpower, position, you can get everything. So you go. That's why Prabhupada was bound to preach. As Sridhar Goswami said, no, I am not qualified to go for preaching. I am in a fall this way. They're so humble mood. They never speak, I am a great player. Whereas Prabhupada giving title to Keshav Goswami Maharaj. To Keshav Goswami Maharaj, to Sridhar Goswami Maharaj. One day Prabhupada was bound to speak. That I am thinking that maybe after my demise, if I go away, who can preach? Now I have hope. Now I have enough hope. Because some of our Guru Varga, like Keshav Goswami Maharaj, like Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Bhavan, they are speaking. Writing some of my Guru Maharaj used to write most of the time, and they are speaking and Rabani Shiva. They all wanted to give full protection to Siddhanta Bani, Srauta Pantha, Amnayo Prahotatyam Harimiho, Sarva Saktim Rasadhim. This slogan I discussed maybe 2 years before. Bhaktivinoda was speaking. So, Amnay Bani, the Srauta Pantha, if you have your full power to give full protection to Srauta Bani, Amnay Bani, Srauta Bani, then you can go for preaching. Otherwise, don't go for peace. You can make some garbage. To clean that garbage, it will take, you know, 500 years, more than 500 years, to clean that garbage already coming in this preaching field. Nobody like to hear Prabhupada. Nobody like to speak. Nobody like to follow. But they can do some function of Prabhupada. Abhirbhakti tiki jai. They can speak. Maharaj, if anybody can speak like that, who can follow? Srila Prabhupada was bound to establish a big mission by the order of Panchatatan Guru Varga. 64 different kind of devotional modes. And Prabhupada wanted to establish 64. And Prabhupada wanted to install Gauriyamat inside the heart of each and everybody. Sarodindu Rai told that Prabhupada, within very short time you are successful to make, you know, over 50 marks. Prabhupada said, come on. 50 marks, it's nothing. Eh? What do you say? Yes, 50 marks, nothing. I wanted to install Gauriyamat inside the heart of all, you know, Jivatma. I wanted to install inside all human beings at least. Of course, he was a little bit disappointed to see some internal situation of the mission before leaving this material world. Prabhupada was feeling disturbance. Disturbance not actually, we can say, this one kind of lila. You know, of course he was little bit disappointed to see some internal situation of the mission before leaving this material world. He never expected that kind of situation to happen. He didn't think it necessary to select or elect an acharya. Why? Because Prabhupada was 100% perfect. That acharya is self-manifested. Why should I go and elect acharya and show them that path? Then everybody can say it is possible to elect one acharya. If self-made, Prabhupada knew it very well. That some of those Guru Varga, our Guru Varga, 100%, they can act as acharya, successful acharya. So, and there was some group against Prabhupada, staying with Prabhupada. So, he didn't think it necessary to select or elect an acharya. Because if Prabhupada is going to show this procedure, everybody can say, okay, Prabhupada selected, so we can... Prabhupada knew it very well. Prabhupada was 100% confident that some of my disciples, they are following me 100%. I am sure if I go away, they can preach all Tattva Siddhanta properly. They can act as acharya. So why should I go to show them that it is possible to elect one acharya? Self-manifested. Self-manifested, acharya, self-manifested, automatically, through Guru Seva, you can self-manifest it, you need not elect. But anyway, to run the mission, he appointed one manager. To run the mission, he appointed one manager. He wrote in one letter, so long as Kunjada, Kunja Bihari Vidyavachan is there here, he is going to take the post of manager, so long as. To run the mission, he appointed one manager. He knew it very well. That to run the Gauriya mission smoothly, need a very, very powerful self-manifested acharya. So, if I am going to show this way, everybody going to show. There can be two reasons. Why Prabhupada was bound to speak that way? Acharya can never be elected by election, meaning voting system. Acharya self-manifested. Why? There can be two possible reasons for why Srila Prabhupada didn't think it necessary to select or elect a successor acharya. First point, maybe Srila Prabhupada could realize that some of those genuine followers, disciples, they are just fit. They are enjoying full Guru Kippa. They are fit. By Guru Kippa, by Guru Seva, they are already self-manifested. Only time can prove. We will have to wait. They are self-manifested Acharya, personality, to take the post of an ideal Acharya, to act as an Acharya. So, Prabhupada didn't think it necessary to select or elect. Whom to select especially? So that's why also the then time, that time the situation was, that time the situation was not so good. Prabhupada was antaryami. So Prabhupada took a decision, okay, if they at least can run 100%, Prabhupada wanted to speak, wanted to speak, that at least if you can, if they can run with this Siddhanta Vichar, they can continue and go on doing seva, still it is very good. You know, new Acharya can come and make a new dogma. It's not allowed. It's Ekayan Pantha. That sensitive situation, sensitive situation was not at all suitable to elect one Acharya. Also, Srila Prabhupada never approved this procedure of election. Prabhupada, I already told. Also, another possibility point can be there, or matter. Another possibility can be there, that Srila Prabhupada never wanted to show such an idealism of selection of Acharya through election. Because this system can go on in future. That's why I told yesterday, a big group from one big international mission there, you know, missionary, they came to ask that our procedure is Ritik Paddhati. One has to make an Acharya. Arey Maharaj, if there is nobody in the society whom Acharya can make Acharya, so Bhatshi he will have to make. So don't try to confuse. My Guru Maharaj wanted to put this question in front of a big Acharya. I cannot speak his name. If you personally speak, come, I can speak. Because there is a big problem can be there. My Guru Maharaj was bound to speak in front of that big Acharya. Maharaj, I have one question. Why you are going to make Acharya him? Why you are going to Maharaj so much fall down, disaster, so much in his life? Why you are again going to make him? Maharaj was bound to cry and speak in front of Bhakti Pumat Puri Goswami Maharaj, Godbrother. Guru Bhai, whom to make? Whom to make Acharya? Whom to give responsibility of this society? That's why he never wanted to make this big society. To run a society, you are bound to make. It is one kind of bondage. Whom to make? I find nobody. One big Acharya, I don't like to name. When he was going to leave body, then all disciples speaking, Maharaj, you are going to leave this material world. Gurudev, you must select one Acharya. Maharaj laughing in strong grief. He was laughing in strong grief. Whom to make Acharya? Whom to make Acharya? I find nobody whom to. Then if you are not going to make any Acharya, then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's loving mission going to be destroyed. Then what to do? Maharaj was firing speech. I establish this mission. By the desire of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, this mission going to be destroyed, I have no objection. Still, I cannot make any wrong selection. I cannot make any garbage. I make this mission by the desire of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. If at all it is a desire of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, then let it be destroyed, this mission. Still, I cannot make wrong selection. Wrong selection means you are going to kill the future generation. There is a situation at present. Jagadananda Pandit used to speak very loudly, gorar ami mukhe bolile nahi chale. Gorar achar, gorar bichar, loile fal phale. Lok dekhano, gora bhaja, tilok matto dhori, goponete attachar, gora dhare churi. English translation you want to hear? Not possible within this short, you know, time. But still I am going to speak. Jagadananda speaking, if somebody going to declare, I am Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I am doing bhajan of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I am doing Gorarami, I am doing. It is not sufficient. You will have to follow all the rules and regulation, etiquette shown by Gauranga. Prabhupada also speak. Those who are going to follow all the rules and regulation of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, automatically they can go for preaching. Automatically, preaching can be done by them. They need not go to foreign country. Foreign country can come to them. They need not go automatically. Can come. And common people are so foolish. You know, Jagadananda speaking, we are going to open one advertisement of Krishna Bhajan, Gaur Bhajan. Jagadananda Pandit speaking, Lok dekhano gora bhaji, it is one kind of, you know, advertisement that I am doing Krishna Bhajan. But actually not me. But I am doing all rubbish. Then Gauranga Mahaprabhu can arrest me through Maya Devi. Through Maya Devi, Gauranga Mahaprabhu going to arrest me. Jagadananda Bhumi. I am doing all rubbish. And in front of you all, I am going to open one nice exhibition. Excellent exhibition of Acharya Sip. Then, big problem. Because of their narrow vision, common people, they are so foolish, they cannot understand why Prabhupada wanted to speak that way. Nobody can understand. They are going to express their, no. Yesterday I was speaking, Snigdhasya Sishyasya Gurava Gujyam Apiyuto. Snigdha Sisho, who is actually going to take all the Siddhanta which are totally harmonized with the heart of Guru Padma, surely he is Acharya. Maybe he is not going to give initiation to anybody. Still he is self-manifested Acharya. You need not, you know, declare that he is Acharya. He is a Siddhanta. So, my external exhibition of Guru Seva, my external exhibition of Guru Seva cannot prove that I am Snigdha Sishya. My external exhibition of Guru Vaishnav Seva cannot prove that I am Snigdha Sishya. Not a matter of joke. He whose heart is totally adjusted with Guru Padma, who can catch the total Siddhanta Vichara Tikesi Acharana, totally harmonized, automatically, in toto. Surely he is Snigdha Sishya. And Snigdha Sishya means Guru. Who is perfect Sishya? He is 100% perfect Guru. See, Guru can unveil all the mystery of bhajan in front of a Snigdha Sishya. Gurudev can realize my heart. Gurudev is not a cheater. Gurudev can realize, maybe Gurudev gone in eternal world. From there he is watching me. If I make any mistake, Gurudev can beat me with chappal. Prabhupada can beat me with chappal. Huh? You are speaking Harikatha, idiot. You are not going to follow. Then who can save me? So I'll have to say, very careful. What I am speaking, I should follow myself. So, if Guru Maharaj is going to give full kippah, Sri Guru can unveil all the secrecy of bhajan in front of a snigdha shishya. Snigdha shishya sya gurava gujyam api uto. There is nothing such secrecy which Gurudev cannot speak in front of a genuine disciple. Snigdha shishya. So in this way, we can get nice succession of acharyaship. I have no objection. I am also get dust particle from their lotus feet. I am also going to wash their lotus feet and drink water. I have no objection. In this way, the succession of acharyaship is never occurs. I can give example. You know, I can give one by example. You can remember Dukhi Krishnadas, Shyamananda Prabhu was the successor of Hidai Chaitanya. Kalna, his part was Kalna, Hidai Chaitanya. Hidai Chaitanya was in line with Gauridas Pandit. Gauridas Pandit and Hidai Chaitanya in line of Gauridas Pandit. Dukhi Krishnadas in the line of Hidai Chaitanya. Follow, you see. Shyamananda Prabhu and Rasikananda Prabhu also in the line of his Guru Padma. You know, this way, even I can show you. If you cannot believe me, if you can come to me, I can show you that how it is possible. Shyamananda Prabhu, Rasikananda Prabhu, sometime there is big mammoth gathering. So many Harikatha going on, Kirtan, and so many, you know, so some genuine, you know, people coming. They want to take Diksha. Shyamananda Prabhu speaking, Hey, you give Diksha to him. Hari? Rasikananda Prabhu giving. Rasikananda Prabhu, hey, you give Diksha to him. How it is possible? If they are not at all over-sanguine, that my grand disciple is in line with Guru Varga. How it is possible for him to speak that way? What to speak? Rasikananda Prabhu, Bhagavad Dharma is so excellent Bhagavad Dharma, so sophisticated. Bhagavad Dharma is so sophisticated that it is only possible through Bhagavad Dharma. It is only possible. Even those who are birds and beasts, they can also get kripa. In the life history of Rasikananda Prabhu, we know. One mad elephant going to kill him. You know, they wanted to kill Rasikananda. You know, that the landlord is very dangerous. He wanted to kill him. Rasikananda standing, and that elephant, mad elephant coming with, you know, shouting, going to kill Rasikananda Prabhu. And Rasikananda Prabhu going to show Abhay Mudra. Abhay Mudra means fearless. Hey, life after life you are showing your madness. Life after life you are showing your madness. Still today you are going to show madness? Why not you do Krishna Bhajan? Hari Maharaj, excellent. That mad elephant coming and bow down in front of Rasikananda Prabhu. Rasikananda Prabhu giving Harinam, Mahamantra. My Guru Padma gave mantra to a calf, very small calf, running here and there. Guru Padma said, bring him here, Baba, you bring him. The small calf, very like deer, you know, running. Guru Padma speaking, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare. I was stunned to see the mercy of Guru Maharaj. Oh, maybe Guru Maharaj feel that calf was due to some mistake taking this life. Who can say? They can see everything. So Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan is so sophisticated, so nice. Even those are beasts and birds can get protection by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava. Bhagavad Dharma, only Bhagavad Dharma, no other Dharma. No other, because it is eternal Dharma. It is Sanatan Dharma. Sanatan means Sada Tanoti Iti Sanatan. Ever, ever, ever propagating factor. It is propagating for infinity pure. Sada sada tanoti. Tanoti is Sanskrit word. Tanoti means propagating. So it is eternally. But all other dharma, they are in the whole world, different kind of dharma, they cannot just prove that it is eternal dharma, only Bhagavad dharma. So I am not going to speak like mad. I am not going to, you know, speak that they have done all wrong, their successive order of Guru Parampara or rubbish, it is one kind of curse. Never spoke that way. Try to fill my heart. I wanted to express what Prabhupada wanted to speak in details. Simply I wanted to explain, nothing else. Eh? When they are running their successive Guru Parampara very flawlessly, very nice way, then there is no question. Very nice. Also, I can quote from Mahabharata here, there are so many things, so that you can cut your prejudicial conception. I am dog of my Guru Varga. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, I didn't... Tumi to Thakur, tomar kukur boliya jaram. Many times in my writing and speech, I repeatedly from heart I declared that I am the dog of my Guru Varga, that's why I am shouting like, I am barking like Guru Varga. I am barking like Guru Varga because I am the dog of Guru Varga. It is the duty of dog what to do. So, you know, from Mahabharata, I can give one or two example, different example. Actually, I already give yesterday one example, and Prabhupada speaking, phalena phalakaranam anumiyate. Phalena phalakaranam anumiyate. By watching the result, you can see everything. By watching the result, what is happening? You know, there you can understand everything. So, Pashupakki hoye taki swarge va niraye tava bhakti rahu bhakti vinod hidaye. Bhaktivinoda Thakur expecting this kind of, you know. So, same, you know, at the bank of Ganga, I already spoke many times before, at the bank of Ganga, one neem tree and one mango tree going to grow up. Ultimately, by their fruits, we can understand this mango tree and it is neem tree. Simply by result, we can understand this mango tree and this fruit. So, that kind of behavior, that kind of activity, that kind of siddhanta they are speaking, it's an automatic fiber. It's an automatic fiber. Why you cannot understand? You are so blind. You cannot understand. So, Guru Parampara is not, you know, bad. You know, Guru Parampara is not bad. We can depend upon Guru Parampara. But, yesterday I told, Bhagavat Parampara and Guru Paramanta Parampara. Prabhupada already, he has shown that Manta Parampara and Guru Parampara should be adjusted in such a way that there cannot be any breakage. Follow. If there is Manta Parampara, you can find some breakage, but Bhagavad Parampara, no. There is same linkage you can get. So, the bad name attributed to the Vaishnavas due to the deviations of the renunciates, those who are going to take a step into the renunciation order, they are doing, some of them doing all rubbish. The bad name attributed to the Vaishnavas due to the deviations of the renunciates. There is a lot of slander against, you know, I can show you. There is a, you know, Prabhupada speaking. There is a lot of slander against the renounced order because of the faults of a certain class of renunciates. It is my desire, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, it is my desire that the pure Vaishnavas renounce those, those, you know, corrupted, you know, sadhus, they should be isolated. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, it is my desire that the pure Vaishnavas renounce those who are fallen and give proper exemplary instruction for the whole world. The number of those false renunciates are gradually increasing, and the time has come to completely isolate ourselves from them. But who is going to do? Who is going to do? Even I told, like a dog, if the whole world going to isolate me, if the whole world going to, you know, isolate me, still I am very happy. If nobody going to hear me, still I am very happy. In Surya Kunda, I like to speak to Suryanarayan Bhagavan. There was nobody there. In front of Prabhu, I am speaking. Hours, 8 hours, 7 hours, 6 hours. Continuously speaking like mad, speaking Harikatha. Who is hearing? Maharaj, I am hearing. I am hearing. So, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, that time has come to completely isolate ourselves from them. Most of the renunciates under the spell of Kali, they are not going to, you know, they are under the influence of Kali, but everybody is going to support them. They have a big gang, but still I am speaking this way. Most of the renunciates under the spell of Kali, be sure, the devotees who is in renounced order is rare at present. At present, that kind of idealism we heard from Srila Bhaktivedanta Madhava Goswami Maharaj. He used to speak that Narottama Prabhu is the ideal brahmachari. Many times, I can discuss this point in the Abhirbhava Bhaktirabhava Titya of Srila Bhaktivedanta Bharati Maharaji. Many times, Bhaktivedanta Madhava Goswami used to speak, Narottama Brahmachari is the ideal brahmachari. Ah, very nice. Ideal brahmachari. Never in whole brahmachari life, stainless. If those who are in renounced order, if their life is not stainless, what example they can prove? What idealism they can preach? Why they are going to make some garbage? The devotees who are in renounced order, the number is very rare. The reason is that unless a person gives up all material desire, and unless he is not going to maintain very good stainless behavior, acharan, to engage himself in perfect Harinam Seva, holy, chanting the holy, with this character and behavior, temperament, until and unless, you know, he is going to do Harinam, he cannot maintain his stainless life. Unless a person gives up all material desire, and unless he is not going to maintain very good stainless behavior, by some efficacy, to engage himself in chanting the holy name constantly, pure way, he cannot, till then, he cannot be able to maintain his purity. So now you understand, purity doesn't mean I can take bath 5 times, 10 times. Purity means continuously you have to maintain purity of your body and mind. Continuously, non-stop, in front of all devotees I can pass lecture and show my idealism. And outside, oh Maharaj, I am staying alone. Who is going to watch? Is kapat. Then Mayadavi can beat me with chappal. Mayadavi can kill me, beat me with chappal. So we need not invite Mayadavi. Automatically Mayadavi can, because Krishna engaging her, She is engaged by Krishna. You know, Sisti Siddhi Palaya Sadhana Shakti Rekha Chayeva Jasya Bhuvanani Durga. I already told, you know. I already told many times. So, he cannot maintain impurity. Bhaktivinoda Thakur continuously he will have to do Harinam, pure character, pure idealism. Then he can maintain his purity. Hence, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is speaking, hence, when the number of renounced people seems to keep increasing more, then this means it is the evil work of Kali. The other reason for why the number increasing, the number of renounced order increasing, sannyasi, everything, is that the other reason for why the number increasing, this kapat increasing, their number is that while giving this base, to them, nobody going to consider their quality. They are suitable or not. Oh, they are coming. The Maharaj, can you give sannyas? You are great. Oh, yes, yes, you come. You shave your head and come to me, I can give. Maharaj, you are not going to understand that. You are not going to calculate. Bhakti Murtau crying. From eternal world, Bhakti Murtau crying. From eternal world, Prabhupada crying. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur. From eternal world, all Siddha Goswami Maharaj crying, Bhakti Maharaj, everybody crying for Guru Bhargava. She is shedding tears. We wanted to give this kind of thing. They are so, you know, unqualified, they cannot take. Oh, nine. Hence, the number of renounced orders seems to increase more. In this means it is the evil work of Kali. The other reason for why the number increasing is that while giving this besha to them, nobody going to consider their quality as suitable or not. Nobody. Everybody like to become guru. Nobody like to become disciple. I like to become disciple. You can teach me. You can teach me. I like to learn. Even I am learning so many things. You can laugh. I am learning so many things. You know, from different devotees all the time, but they think I am joking. They think I am joking. I am speaking truly. I am learning something. Always I am watching the qualities of Guru Vaishnava Vaishnavi. Sometimes they think I am joking with them. Not. I am learning really. So they are not going to consider their quality. That is the reason. As a result, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, as a result, the number of more and more unqualified, renounced people leads to an increase in social problems and more discrepancies in conduct, which will cause the destruction of this Vaishnava Dharma. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. Bhaktivinoda Thakur was crying and speaking 150 years back. Bhaktivinoda Thakur could realize they are going to follow this, you know, track of Mayadevi. Bhaktivinoda Thakur was speaking. All Vaishnava Dharma can come to break down. But anyway, Shuddha, pure Dhara flow must be there. If a person after taking sannyas becomes becomes entangled in material desire, then he is befit of his original ashram. He should go back to previous ashram, but they are not going because we are giving some fuel. Fire is already there. Oh, Maharaj coming. They know that sannyasi, that acharya already have some children in foreign country. But still they are not going to throw him out. Maharaj coming, we like to hear some, you are going to die. Idiot number one. You know, if a person after taking sannyas, you know, becomes entangled in material desire, then he is befit, he should go back to his original ashram. If he enters into household life, is good. But still, you should remember, no long he can get the title and gotra. He cannot get any title and gotra of previous ashram, because now he is out of varna and ashram. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. There was a big evolution. When I spoke this Harikatha, maybe 10 years back, they all make one group and come in front of big boss. Hey, Maharaj speaking this way. Hey, I am not speaking, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, because he is now out of Varnavang ashram. He is outside the scope of Varnasam Dharma, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. He can go back and lead a family life, but he is surely outside the scope of Varna Ashram Dharma. About Varnasam Dharma, so long discussion was there. I think still today it is not clear to you. So foolish that you are going to, you know, jump into fire in the name of marriage. And you are giving argument to me, Maharaj, I wanted to save that man. You try to save yourself first. You are going to save him himself. You know everything, still you are jumping into fire. You are hearing Harikatha, foolish, kapat. You know. So you should, you know, who is going to spoil this sannyas dharma, you should go back to home. But they are going to maintain thousands of such cases. They are going to maintain sannyas, brace, danda, everything. They are giving lectures, sitting in sabha, giving lecture, collecting money. Maharaj, I was totally disturbed. When I wanted to save the sannyas of some idiot, but I am also idiot, why I wanted to help him? After that, he started collecting money in the name of Sam Baba, this, that, make bank balance, whereas he already declared, I am already fall down. But still now, they are traveling with sannyas base. Who is going to Vishwa Vaishnava Rasa vanish. Vishwa Vaishnava Rasa vanish. Like camphor. Camphor, you know? Vanish. Who can show Vishwa Vaishnava Rasa is there? Or garbage going on? He is outside the scope of Varnavang Ashram. He is outside the scope of Varnavang Ashram. Only by heartfelt repentance and by giving up hypocrisy, he can absolve himself from his fallen state and gain the grace of Supreme Lord, Guru Bhargava. A fallen sannyas can no way take up the robe, sannyas best dress of a sannyasi, as that will be equivalent, tantamount to hypocrisy. It is nothing else, hypocrisy. You know, it is equivalent to hypocrisy. How we can expect? Whereas Bhaktivinoda, I can discuss, maybe this discussion can go long time to open your eyes, because you are blind. I can show what Bhaktivinoda Thakur. It is the main duty of main acharyas to give full protection to Siddhanta Bani. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, to arrest this perverted tide, this corruption, this all problems happening in the society, for the purification, to keep the flow pure. Parampara, it is the duty of acharya. Who is going to discharge this duty? They can going to kick me, my chest. I am sure they are going to kick me on my chest. But of course I can take it as blessing. They are going to kick me, that means I am successful. I am successful in my representation. That's why they are going to kick me, kill me. Now I can go on discussing all important, why Prabhupada wanted to speak that way. I can refer different example from Mahabharata, Puran, Bhagavatam, all different. I can go on to prove to prove the unique Acharya Siva Prabhupada. Always Prabhupada wanted to speak. You know, we don't want to see temporary Acharya Siva. Whole life Prabhupada wanted to show us eternal Acharya Siva. Prabhupada wanted to show us eternal Acharya Siva. You are busy. You are busy to run your society. Oh, Maharaj, how we can be that Maharaj, select him Acharya. You can go and decide. After hearing this Siddhanta, you can, what was the, his character, it is, and I am not going to fight with anybody. One Acharya is going to, he can make Acharya. And also, he can carry out whole power if he is in line. If he is not in line, who is going to? We'll have to detect, no? From Mahabharata also I can give example, but not now, time cannot permit. I'll have to run for some other seva right now. So I can discuss this point next day. I can give you example. Krishna Bhagavan speaking in front of Uddhavji Maharaj. Uddhav asking, why same guru, same parampara going? Why some disturbance, some dirty things coming? How is possible? Uddhavji Maharaj asking, and Krishna Bhagavan going to speak, give answer. Krishna speaking, evam prakriti vaichitrat vidyante matayo ninam paramparjena kesanchit pasanna matayo apare. This sloka I can explain. This way, due to the diversity of human nature, automatically, due to their previous sanskar, there was diversity, sin in their opinion or vichar. Some started following principle shown by previous Guru Varga, and some started following all pasanda heretic procedure operations. They started. I can explain this point. Evam prakriti vaichitrat vidyante matayo ninam paramparjena kesanchit pasanna matayo apare. I can explain this sloka in big way. Different kind of questions coming in front of me from different parts of the world. And today I want to some Vasudha Ma from Slovenia putting some question. So I have no right to write, better I can speak in Harikatha. So, topics is almost same. So, I like to... Some practical examples of contamination of bhakti with karma, jnana and yoga. You are so foolish, you cannot understand. So many harikatha. You know, is doing yoga for health purpose also not good? Yeah. You are putting this question. Now I am going to give answer. Previously, now I am going to answer, try to understand. Previously, it was possible to follow the enthusiastic way of Nam Sankirtan, dancing and singing, shown by Mahaprabhu. It was a parampara line. Previously, it was possible, I myself also, at the time of Guru Maharaj, red cloth, used to dance like monkey. In Sankirtan, everybody knows. But now I don't find that kind of place where I can dance. Also, age also going up, still I can dance. That's not a big way if you can give me blessing. So, dancing, dry dancing is not good. If I'm not feeling, dancing mean is the expression of your heart. It's called dancing, singing. So, dancing and singing, dry dancing, not good. So previously, it was possible to follow the enthusiastic procedure, way of Nam Sankirtanam, dancing, singing, but at present, that kind of environment is lost. Not there. So Mahaprabhu also going to check his mood. When outside people there, Mahaprabhu going to check his tears and Baba, Prabhupada also. So to get control over your mind and body, you can take the help of pranayama and yoga. But be careful. That pranayama and yoga you can do, it is approved by Krishna in Bhagavatam. Krishna speaking about pranam. But you should do with full mood of bhakti. Even then, when you are doing pranayam, your mind should be constantly in touch with Krishna, Gauranga, Nityananda's lotus feet. You know, to keep your health okay, but what is the purpose for which you can maintain your health? Mahaprabhu speaking, how I can maintain this insect? This my body is like insect. Prana patanga kana vitha. Vibho, vitha vibhor me. I am useless. I am going to maintain this, you know, my body and mind is, you know, useless body and mind. It's like insects. What use? I cannot do Krishna bhakti. So this point should be there. So you can do. You can find out some time, pure place, pure time, and can concentrate onto the lotus feet of Nityananda, Dhameshwar, Nityananda, Dhameshwar, Gaur. You can concentrate all Panchatattva by Paupat, you know, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Vigraha, but constant. There should be no breakage. Is also helpful. You can do. Because our continuous Harikatha, if I am speaking Harikatha for continuously 2.5 years, half hours or 3 hours, I have no scope to think about other thing. Until and unless I am continuously in touch with Prabhupada and Guru Varga, I cannot speak Siddhanta. There can be some breakage. So better procedure is to sing Harinam Sankirtan. I can explain this Siddhanta. But you ask, that's why I am giving answer. So to get control over your mind and body, you can take help of pranayama and yoga, but if full attention can be given to Harinam, Sankirtan, Harikatha, then no need of any other things. Of course, your each and every action, even pranayama yoga, should be directly related with bhakti. If you break, you're doing Ekadashi, somebody speaking Pobat. Somebody doing Maharaj, Ekadashi is very good. If we follow Ekadashi, then our health can be very good. Idiot. If with this mood, if I am going to follow Ekadashi, then what use Ekadashi? No! We are doing Ekadashi not to get any result except bhakti. Except bhakti. Bhakti can begets bhakti. Without bhakti, why you are doing bhakti? To get more bhakti. Why you are doing bhakti? To get more bhakti. Nothing else. No reason can be there. So of course, each and every your action should be directly related with bhakti devi. Bhakta vihina paradalakshay kiptascha kamadi taranga madhe kipa mai tvam saram papanya binde namaste charanarvinda. Now second answer. Second, your question. One devotee, because some practical example you want, the contamination of bhakti with karma, jnana and yoga. Try to understand. One devotee in one mart, cooking for bhoga in the daytime, but he is taking salary. One devotee cooking for bhoga at any mandir, but is taking money. This is contaminated with karma. His bhakti is not pure bhakti. Maybe he is having some initiation, doing harinam, everything. That is contaminated. It's karma. Kormi. It's not. This become an example of contamination of bhakti with karma. And like kapat guru shevak. Those who are kapat guru shevak, they are serving this way. Inside their heart, there is one cross. Outside, they are going to show that I am very chaste lady. Doing Guru Seva, his Guru Seva is contaminated. He is going to expect that Gurudev can make me Acharya, next Acharya with this. Then he is cross. He is, you know. And Karma Mishra Bhakti, I can give example of Karma Mishra Bhakti of Rantidev. Rantidev was successful in your Karma Mishra Bhakti. Rantidev was 100% successful in his Karma Mishra Bhakti. Rantidev could relate Kuntidi was successful to relate each and everything with Krishna, Parabrahma, Paratpara Kriyeshwar. That's why Rantidev was successful, though he was in karma marg. Karma marg means karma yog, various karma mishra bhakti. He was successful. I can explain. I already explained in Jain before, 5, 7 years, 10 years before, and also many times I quoted that Rantidev was successful because he was successful to relate each and every incident, every fraction of second, with Krishna. That's why he was successful. Whereas Bharat Maharaj was not successful. Bharat Maharaj was not successful because Bharat Maharaj was doing bhajan in Nepal, one very nice place. You know, at the bank of Gandaki Nadi, Kali Gandaki. Very holy place. Bharat Maharaj was not successful because gradually he was deviated from the track of bhajan. But actually the procedure of Gyan Mishra Bhakti, Bharat Maharaj, his bhajan was more elevated than the procedure of bhajan of Rantidev. But Bharat Maharaj was not successful because Bharat Maharaj was deviated. He was, you know, day by day he deviated from the track of bhajan. He was giving attention to the deer and a calf. And a deer, you know, a small, you know, deer baby has deviated. So couldn't do bhajan. So you see, this way actually, Jnana, if can find an application in the field of personal position. Suppose I have Jnana. I am going to take advantage of my Jnana. Going to pass lecture, collect money, then my Jnana is useless. So Jnana, you know, if going to find an application, personal patishtha instead of devotional purpose, this can be an example of contamination of bhakti with Jnana. Mayavadi also taken advantage, contamination, they have no bhakti. Prahlad Maharaj was, you know, Gyan Mishra Bhakti, but Prahlad Maharaj was successful. Nishingadeva was very happy. Prahlad Maharaj Bhakti also, Gyan, you know. And yoga, if done to get some yoga vaibhav, like some Ashtanga Yogi, they are going to get some example. But anyway, it is written in Gita, Bhaktivinoda Thakura explaining, without any touch of bhakti, in no marg, in any track, karma yoga, gyan yoga, dhyan yoga, bhakti yoga, any track, without the touch backing of bhakti, you are not going to get any result. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, it is the main siddhanta. Any result you are getting in any track, you are following. But bhakti, you must get some bhakti. Without that, you are not going to get it. Follow what I say? So, yoga, if done to get some yoga vaibhav, become an example of contamination of bhakti by yoga, by the Ribhu Rishi, you know Ribhu Rishi? Radharani the great, the lotus feet of Radharani Krishna going to worship. Radharani herself, she is speaking, Prabhu, Radharani speaking to Krishna. Oh Prabhu, oh Krishna, you should, you know, give some, you know, you can give some kippa to the Ribhu Rishi. I've been there in different forests of Vrindavan, very secret here and there, in Kamavan. Ribhu Rishi used to do bhajan. Baba, dangerous. Nobody can disturb. Ribhu Rishi was successful. Also, I can give day by day, you can go on hearing, I can give example. Today, time cannot permit. Sauvari Rishi doing yoga, but his yoga was disturbed due to aparad. I can give example, but today time cannot permit. I will have to run for some other seva. If I have done any mistake, please excuse me. If you have any doubt, you can speak in front of me. Yeah. You have to speak in front of me so that I can hear and try to find solution of your doubt. That is my request unto your lotus feet. Kipaya hori kirtana murti dharam dharani varharuk gaura janam janakadika vasala snigda padam pranamami sada prabhupada padam pranamami sada prabhupada padam pranamami sada prabhupada padam vanchakalpataru sikhe pasindu bhavishya patitanang pavana bhavishya jyo namo.